CA Foundation, November 2009, Sale of Goods Act, important questions. Sir, Sale of Goods Act, I think unpaid seller is very, 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 very important. Unpaid seller as well as unpaid buyer rights. Remember, mug it up, you need to. Unpaid seller, basically the seller who has not been paid for the goods sold by him, either in part or full. Or if any negotiable instrument has been delivered to him, it has been returned dishonored. He is an unpaid seller. What are the rights of an unpaid seller? Unpaid seller has got the two rights, basically right against goods and right against buyer. Right against goods, till the time the goods are in existence, right against goods can be exercised. The various right against goods are right of lien, right of stoppage in transit, and right of resale. Sir, right against buyer, if the goods are not in existence, he can exercise right against buyer. What are the various rights? Suit for price, suit for interest, suit for damages, suit for repudiation of contract before due date. These are the basic things. Now, right of lien can be exercised till the time the goods are in possession with the seller and the buyer defaults in the payment of the goods. So in that case, he can retain the possession of the goods till the time the payment is being made. Right of stoppage in transit, the buyer has become insolvent, the seller has parted with the possession and delivered it to the carrier to deliver it to the buyer, and he comes to the knowledge, and it comes to the knowledge of the buyer that seller that the buyer has become insolvent, so he can talk to the carrier and he can basically take back the position, regain the position of the goods. So in that case, the right of stoppage in transit can be exercised. And the place where right of stoppage in transit, the place where right of lien ends is the place where right of stoppage in transit starts. In case of right of lien, the seller retains the position. In case of right of stoppage in transit, he regains the position. Sirji, right of stoppage in transit can only be exercised when the buyer is insolvent. It is not in the case of right of lien. Right of resale, the seller can exercise the right of resale only after giving a notice to the buyer of his intention to sell the goods and giving a reasonable opportunity. That is what it is all about. And in case of right of resale of perishable goods, there is no need to give any kind of notice. The seller can very well sell the goods. If there is any deficiency, he can exercise the right against buyer for a suit for price and interest and all those things. And if there is a surplus, he can retain it or he can give it back. It's as per his discretion, nothing else. So this is very important for you people. Then in case of unit 3, sale of goods on approval or return basis or for cash basis, these two points are very important. Approval basis, if the goods are being sold to the or delivered to the buyer on sale on approval or return basis, it can only be treated as a sale if any of the three conditions are fulfilled. The buyer does not return the goods within the specified time or a reasonable period of time, he does any act which is inconsistent with the ownership of the goods, or he does something which makes the goods non-returnable, in that case it will be treated as a sale. In case of cash sales, only for cash, if the buyer doesn't pay the cash, the goods will not be sold to the buyer. It will be returned back to the seller. Delivery, voluntary transfer of possession of goods from buyer to seller. Voluntary transfer of position of goods from one place to another, nay, from one person to another, that is the buyer to the, from the seller to the buyer. Remember this thing. When you are writing it, transfer of position from one person to another, from one place to another. Write it properly. Voluntary transfer of position of goods from seller to buyer. And delivery can take various forms. It is actual, symbolic, constructive, and symbolic delivery. That is what it is all about. Now, ascertained goods, you know it. Implied conditions and implied warranty is very important. You need to remember the difference also. And implied condition can be breach of condition can be treated as breach of warranty. There are four cases, you need to remember that also. This is also very important. And in case of unit 1, difference between sale and agreement to sale and sale and hire purchase, basically 2 to 3 points needed. And what do you mean by goods and what are the different types of goods? These are the things which you need to remember. I think the entire thing will be from this only. The rest, if you can manage, you do revise it once. And this is where important topics are all about. Regarding how to attempt the paper, I will be uploading the video tomorrow. Till that time, study hard, study well and try. This should be your last attempt in foundation, and you people must appear in intermediate in the next November. Thank you, sir. All the best.